Let me preface this video by saying that the feedback is not enough, but Jagex has responded to our feedback on Hero Pass, so let's talk about it. Whenever you're ready, grab your cup of tea, sit back, relax, and enjoy. Jagex states that they've been listening and discussing our feedback and are looking to make the system better for everyone. Now, I want you to remember this sentence. This post is for some key areas they are already investigating. Okay. This starts with daily missions. Daily missions were balanced with the intention of moderately active players, according to Jagex, being able to complete them in 20 to 40 minutes or faster when doing the spotlighted task for that daily. Jagex acknowledges we like our fast dailies for a chunk of experience, a burst of experience if you will, and is reducing the time it takes to complete dailies to around 15 minutes tops, and buffs the amount of XP you gain from dailies 1 and 2. Dailies 1 and 2 will now each provide a large XP lamp each, which, if I recall correctly, means that daily missions 1 and 2 will now give the exact same XP as an extended daily without needing to extend it. Nice one, Jagex. Completing the daily with a spotlighted task will still complete it twice as fast, so far it's looking good. Now, something we didn't know is that Jagex plans to or intends to add more special missions for future content releases during this battle pass, so that you'll be able to get more hero points from those special missions, which give 1, 2, or 5,000 points depending on the mission, which is good. As for RMM players, they are looking into discussing the topic of RMM players being able to claim that XP lamp from daily missions. So far, in an unofficial poll in a big RMM Discord, it seems that the majority of RMM players are against this. Please keep in mind that this is an unofficial poll, I'm just sharing the news here, and I'm not going to dabble too deep into Iron Man accounts because it's not my place to talk about it as I'm a Mainscape player. I did see a lot of concerns about the amount of oddments Iron Man players were getting, so maybe that's something up for a change as well. Going back to daily missions, there are two big things I'm missing here. Firstly, the reintroduction of Treasure Hunter keys as a reward from daily challenges, now called daily missions. There is not a single good reason why these need to be removed as long as people can buy Treasure Hunter keys. Secondly, there needs to be some kind of save up and store mechanic for daily missions if Jagex's goal really is to reduce dailyscape. As it stands, for every set of daily 1, 2, and 3 you miss, you will need to play an hour and a half to catch up. By introducing a save and store mechanic for, let's say, 7 days, you would allow players to catch up on their dailies and reduce the need to log in every day without hurting the amount of hours they play every single week or month. Of course, I'm not sure what their goal is here, but if their goal is to have people play a lot more, then would it really matter if they played 15 minutes every single day for 7 days, or all of that time at once on a single given day? Why is that so important? Well, because the Hero Pass is incredibly grindy, which we're going to get to in just a second, and these daily missions account for 21% of the total points you need to complete the entire Hero Pass. So even if they take 50 minutes, even if they take 5 minutes, which admittedly is quite short, having to log in every single day is not a nice feeling if you aren't feeling the game. If the goal is truly to improve and reduce dailyscape, the solution is simple. Stop making at least a portion of the player base feel like they have to log in every single day. And the portion of the player base that feels forced are the ones that want to complete the pass, obviously. Not everyone is going to care about completing the pass, I understand that. But if we're trying to reduce dailyscape here, we're going to need to allow players to save up their daily missions and complete them whenever they feel like it, just like the general weekly missions. I mean, the mechanics are literally already in the battle pass, but it isn't applying to daily missions as they still have an expiration timer. Now, those missions are still incredibly important because Jagex is not yet adjusting progression rates. Even if you're completing every single mission and perhaps a couple of additional special missions they're going to add, it's still going to take you 1.5 to 3 hours per day to complete this battle pass. In the news post, Jagex says that moderately active players could achieve level 99 in the battle pass, which isn't the end, with their normal playtime. And whatever active players are, which is 30% of the player base according to Jagex, would be able to complete the entire battle pass with their normal average playtime. Now, that's most definitely based on real statistics, although why would you design a system that 2/3 or 70% of your player base is not going to be able to complete? Mind you, some of the more controversial rewards, such as Trailblazer charges behind the premium pass, yes, the premium pass, are locked at level 107. Surely a battle pass with an infinite task system after completing it should be balanced around the majority of your player base. It's so hard to comprehend how they thought this was going to go down well. I really do not understand. It should be like at least 40% faster to make up for whatever the moderately active players are missing opposed to the active players in terms of playtime. I would hope that a battle pass with an infinite system after finishing it would be balanced around like 80% of the player base at least. The majority of players need to be able to complete the battle pass, not the minority. Players should not be spending 1.5 to 3 hours per day completing this battle pass after completing every single mission. And even though this is the supposed first feedback post, Jagex not addressing one of the biggest issues with this battle pass with their first bit of feedback feels like a slap in the face. It's like your entire car breaking down after an accident, the local shop calling you and saying, hey, we fixed your cracked window, but the car still won't start. The other big issue are those content buffs that are distributed quite unfairly towards free members and premier players. The content buffs, of which the Chaos Ward and Trailblazer ones were the controversial ones, according to Jagex, were a reason to incentivize players to check out certain content. Why not just make it a special weekly event? Why does it have to be in an MTX system? Why do premier players get more of these buffs than regular paying members that are already paying for their game? It's not a fair way of distributing game-changing buffs, which could get more powerful as we go, which is the worrying part about these kind of buffs being split between premier and regular members and being part of a battle pass. The very least they're doing is they're going to have a look at where these buffs are placed in the hero pass to maybe place them a little bit more forward, at least that's what I assume, to reduce the amount of, hey, you need to do this to get these buffs, otherwise you're missing out, FOMO feeling. It's also worth noting that Jagex apologized for presenting the Hero Pass as a major update, which is good to see. In conclusion, Jagex is awake and listening, and it's good to see them at least adjusting things, although I really hope that this isn't the last we'll hear from it. There's still improvements to be made, specifically on balancing those content buffs, the speed at which you progress for playing your way, i.e. not completing missions the entire time, and the reduction of daily scape. It's worth noting that I may not make another dedicated video on this topic and instead add it into the usual weekly news unless Jagex does something out of the ordinary. Oh, and if you don't feel satisfied by these changes just yet, don't act that way and let your voice be heard. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.